In today's Madden 21 video, I'm going to be breaking down why Deion Sanders is the best wide receiver in Mutt, and he is a must-add on any lineup in the game. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time to watch today's video. Now, if you're new to the channel, if you have any questions about what I do here, what we do is we basically try to get better at Madden 21 so that we can help you get better at this game. And so we give offensive tips, defensive tips. Every now and then we sprinkle in some Mutt tips that we're going to be doing today, do some breakdowns, and kind of explain some of these ratings. So if you're interested in taking your Madden game to the next level, I would highly encourage you to go ahead and click the subscribe button at the bottom right hand corner of your screen. One more thing I would encourage you to do is if you have not already joined my text message membership, it is completely free for you to do that. Literally all you have to do to join is shoot me a text message. My number is in the top left hand corner of your screen. And basically what you get, why you should join this, is every single week we sit down for about 45 minutes to an hour and break down a full-fledged free offensive or defensive scheme for you. So in the past, we've broken down the Carolina Gun Bunch that you see a lot of pro players running. We broke that down in our text message membership, I believe, 8 to 9 weeks ago. A lot of the, you know, like the, you saw D-Croft running wide off trips pats. We broke that down this last week. So these are high-level stuff. These are stuff that pro players are using, the top-of-the-line schematics in Madden 21. We've broken down split close, which you see some pro players using right now. We've broken down, like I said, gun wild trips pass, gun a slot offset. We broke down defensively big nickel over G, which is one of the most popular defenses in the pro circuit right now. So if you are looking for high-level schemes that are going to be able to put you on par with people, I would highly encourage you to go ahead and join that text message membership. It's completely free to join it, and I think it's going to be very, very useful to you. Okay, so now I want to talk about Deion Sanders, and I want to talk about why he's so good. So on my team, you see that I have Deion Sanders. I'm actually thinking of making a Dallas Cowboys theme team. I probably will, to be honest with you. I think the Dallas theme team is actually looking really, really good right now. But what I'm going to do is hop into the item binder, and I just want to show you this, these ratings that he comes into the game with. So before Deion Sanders, there was Lance Allworth, right? And Lance Allworth was really good. I mean, he's not terrible by any means. But before that, it was Chad Johnson. And so I just wanted to go through and show you, you know, kind of the evolution. So we started with Terry McLaurin. At the beginning of the year, Terry McLaurin was really good. He had 96 speed when you came him up with Sprinter. Obviously, if you have the theme team on him, he gets him up to 98. He had all the route running thresholds. But the one issue with Terry McLaurin is, as you can see here, his archetype. His archetype is a deep threat archetype. So when you go to try to put an ability, if you go to try to put an ability on him, like for example, a slot apprentice or something like that, what you're going to find is you're not going to be able to do that. You'll see here that if you go through his abilities, the thing that he does get is these deep in and deep out elites. As you can see, that's actually really good. But the problem is he doesn't get like, Slot-O-Matic is 4 AP. Route Technician, he doesn't even get it, as you can see here. He doesn't get Slot Apprentice. Things like that that he couldn't get that were actually really, really important abilities to have on your player. That's why route running archetypes, which is why when Chad Johnson came in the game, he actually was probably the best wide receiver in Mutt. A lot of people you saw using this guy. Why? Because you can see here, I could put Slot-O-Matic on him for 3 AP, save a cap point, and also Slot Apprentice as well, which is really, really good. The other thing I could have done is I could have put, you know, Outside Apprentice for only 1 AP, just different things like that to save cap. So route running archetypes as a general rule, at least so far this season, have been the best wide receivers to get. Well, when Deion Sanders came out, the one issue with Terry McLaurin was Terry McLaurin had top of the line speed, whereas in Tyreek Hill, the same kind of thing, right? He had 94 speed stock. And then when you would get him up with Sprinter and theme teams and all that, he could get up to 99 speed. Well, Deion Sanders, what you'll notice here is he's actually at 97. This is with no theme teams. You can get Deion Sanders to 99 speed really, really easily. But if you take a look at his, if you take a look at what he actually can do for you, he has really, really good route running. He has 99 short route running, 95 medium, 91 deep. All of the thresholds are hit. And what I actually like a lot about him is if you notice about these route runnings, right, when you're at 95 and higher, that's pretty much the best that you can get as far as a route running deal. And so from that point over, I honestly think it's literally just about speed from that point. But as you can see, those two things are hit. He hits all the thresholds. Now, if you take a look at his abilities, this is what's really powerful because, again, he's a route running archetype. So he gets route technician for only 2 AP, which means you're going to be able to save cap. You're going to be able to put more cap into maybe your offensive line or maybe another ability for a receiver or things like that. And that's why Deion Sanders is so good, because he's able to get these different things like route tech. Before Dan, the other thing is he actually gets this mid and mid out elite, which I think these actually could be really decent abilities. But the one thing I did want to talk about really quickly is because of his overall, you see that he also gets the deep in elite and deep out elite for only 1 AP. Since before Deion Sanders, if you were a route running archetype, that wasn't the case. You couldn't get that for that rating. But because he's a route running archetype and because of his overall and because of his high level speed and high level ratings, he's able to get all of this stuff, right? He's able to get all this stuff, which is really nice because he basically can get every ability in the game. The only ability that he can't get is like jukebox or, you know, some of this like stuff like here, which is not really that big of a deal, at least in the big picture of offense and what you're going to be doing as far as your offense goes. But as you can see, I mean, this guy's just a beast. He can do everything you need. The big thing I want to see is when we could get a playmaker receiver out there. That would be actually really, really cool, just to kind of see if that would make any difference on things. But as far as what is the top of the line cards, but that's Deion Sanders. If you don't have him on your team, you're at a disadvantage. This guy's a beast. This guy is the best wide receiver in the game, and it's literally not even close. There's no receiver even close to him. He comes with 95 speed. I'm telling you, I'm going to probably build a Dallas Cowboys theme team because it's going to get him over 99 speed. It's going to help Deion Sanders as well, and it's going to be able to help Lance Allworth, who I believe Lance Allworth is the second best wide receiver in the game, because Lance Allworth goes through and he has that same route running archetype, same build, so he's going to have all of that stuff with the abilities. He's only one speed slower than Deion Sanders, but as you can see here, his route running is much, much better. He's got 95 deep, 96 mid, 98 short once you chemistry him up and put play fake on him. So this guy's a beast as well and is going to be really, really, really effective. With a theme team, this is 98 speed and 99 speed respectively for those two guys. So if you could do something to get Tyreek Hill up, then you're going to have really, really fast receivers, and you're always going to be able to threaten the defense down the field. So anyway, that's just a quick video. Just wanted to share with you why I believe Deion Sanders is the best receiver in the game. If he's not on your team, you want to work toward getting him on your team. Sell everything for this guy. The must-have cards right now, in my opinion, are Rich Gannon, Deion Sanders, and Troy Vincent. Those three cards are super critical to your success. And so I would highly encourage you, if you haven't picked those guys up, to go ahead. And then obviously Chris Cooley. Chris Cooley is like a no-brainer must-have tight end. He's the best tight end in the game, at least right now. So anyways, guys, that's the video. If you want to pick up those schemes, just shoot me a text message. My New England Patriots offensive ebook is also available in the description, and that ebook works amazing with these players. So far, undefeated in weekend league for the last 2 weeks, can continue to keep grinding. But if you have any questions, just shoot me a text message. Thank you so much for your support, and we'll see you in our next video coming here in a few short hours.